The solution is also about the dashboard, using the dashboard. At the beginning, it was very difficult because at the end of the session, it tried to collect username of participant and add those username on the dashboard. But now it's very easy because participants need just to subscribe to the tools, and directly the username can add on the dashboard. This is it's very useful for her, that organizer, about that. Yes.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Aristide, for sharing. I'm happy it's a great solution for one of the pain points organizers go through, which is about the amount of time they spend in trying to organize some of these events, knowing fully well that I'm also a volunteer organizer. And I'm really excited learning the different ways that communities are experiencing the use of this tool. And I'll come to you, SNM. It's not every day you find a female organizer from the Francophone community. And it will be interesting to learn how useful you think you are seeing this tool for you, particularly as an organizer, and how this is supporting your organizing activity in the Francophone community. And I'll leave it to you, George.
Okay. Sinam, you have a floor to talk to us about your using of tools.
Bonjour tout le monde, je m'appelle Essenam Foumé, je suis membre de la communauté wikimédienne du Sénégal et en tant qu'organisatrice d'événements, l'outil est intéressant pour nous. Pourquoi? Parce qu'au début, lorsqu'on a commencé, lorsqu'on veut faire un événement, on crée un Google Drive, un caisse-form, merci beaucoup, pour que les gens puissent s'inscrire. Mais après, on est obligé de venir collecter leur email si on veut leur envoyer des informations supplémentaires. Et aussi, ça rejoint un peu le fait d'ajouter parfois leur username. Mais avec l'outil aujourd'hui, si on crée l'événement à l'avance, on met directement sur nos publications, allez vous inscrire à cet endroit et ça nous permet de collecter déjà les usernames. Et aussi avec la mise à jour nouvelle qui a été faite, on peut directement aussi leur envoyer des mails sans aller courir dans un autre, sur une autre interface, et ça nous et permet d'avoir un gain de temps.
The first plus was the time. We have a gain of time. At the beginning, before the tools, we use a Google form to collect email and username of participant. It was very difficult to manage. But now with the tool, it's possible to have directly a username, also possible to change with participant, to ask to them, for example, we can also share some information with participant. Now it's possible now to send an email to participant just when the participant can register to the event, because it's possible to have email of participant. It's also possible to have username of participant. Now it's very easy to communicate with participant, because before that it was very difficult when we use the Google Doc, Google Form.
Thank you so much, SNM. I know that the time crunch is always the issue at times. And it's really intriguing to learn that this is helping you as an organizer to spend it with time. And I'll come to you, Juliet. I know that yours is a very exciting case because oftentimes we just want to learn from the organizers how they experience the two years. But here we have today a participant who is also participating in some of these events that are using this tool. And we would really love to learn about your experience as a participant when you especially reflect on how you have been experiencing participation in campaigns in the movement before the arrival of the tool and how you feel now that you have access to this tool. Could you please tell us and please let us know what community you are. So,
hey, good morning, everyone. I'm coming from the Igbo Wikimedia user group as well as the Nigerian Wikimedia user group as well. Sorry, community, Nigerian community. All right, as a participant using this event prior to the establishment or the coming of this event, too, we were faced with this issue of IP blocks. I can remember being blocked twice, and then I have to reach out to the organizers or facilitators to see if there is a way it can be resolved. Well, and at the end of the day, it was resolved actually, but it took a lot of time before I could join the contest. It was quite stressful. Then another one is before the discovery of this event too, we oftentimes have to log in with our Wikipedia account, sign in our usernames in the participant section, as well as join the dashboard. And sometimes to join this dashboard will not be easy. You still have to reach to the organizers to do it for you manually instead of clicking on the join because of one issue or the other. But as at last week or last month that I used this event to, I was wow. I just have to do this subscription, and then before you know it, my name is already on the dashboard, as well as helping the facilitators to track my contributions. And I was amazed at this innovation. It's really an exciting one. So I will encourage each and every one of the facilitators at least to employ the use of this event too in their programs or the contest that is being held, so that it will as well help them deal with this IP block and the rest of the other issues that we usually complain about. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Juliet. Yes, sure, please.
Sorry, I had to ask. I have to warn everyone that there are newbies around us, so I've been waiting to hear what this tool is all about. We were busy talking about how good it is, how excellent it is, but what is the tool? Where is it? Where can we find it? Who has access to it? Something like that. Thank you.
So, Okay. So thank you all for sharing your experience. It's so good to hear about that. So before now, I've been reaching out to Euphemia because I've been going on the meta page for this event on how to really activate the tool and all that, but it has not really been easy, to be sincere. So I don't know if I think it will do all of us a good, it will be very profitable if we can maybe see a practical as to how this works seriously and how it can be assessed. And again, the last question is, what if I don't want to organize a campaign? I just want to train people. Can I just use that? Yeah.
To answer your question, which also has to do with your own question, we had an office hour about the two. I think, Georges, when was it again? It was last month, October. Did you happen to attend? Okay. So that, because we are at that point where we have started
building updates for the two. Before we had that office hour, the two was basically about helping people to register, or let me start from what the tool is all about and then come back to the features. So you heard what they have narrated here about the pain points that organizers go through. And because we know that organizing is an important element of the Wikimedia movement that helps us to bring in the content, we figure that it's important to make sure that organizers have all the necessary tools that they need to make organizing easy for them. And the Wikimedia Foundation set out on a journey to build a kind of event center that houses organizing tools. And event registration tool is just the first tool of that event center amongst the several ones that are still coming. And the event registration tool is to help people to garner participants that can easily register on the meta page that is enabled, the tool has enabled. But one thing you need to know is that for you to use the tool, you have to have what we call the organizer rights, which so many of us are already getting by now, and some more people are beginning to get this. And we have a Telegram group where people are also, you know, there to have easy access to information. We're going to share all of this on the Wiki Indaba Telegram group, so you have access to this. So it's just more about helping registration process. But one thing that is important for us to note is that it's not just about signing up on the meta page and then having it also extend to the campaign's outreach program and outreach dashboard. Is also helping you to do the onboarding process. Like you heard what she said, normally you would maybe use Google Forms and the rest to obtain email addresses and all that. Then maybe you create Telegram groups or WhatsApp groups and start onboarding yourself and all that. But this tool makes it easy for you to have the link of your group where you have it in such a way that anybody who registers for that automatically has access to that group and do the onboarding right away, and then make it easy for you and also save time for you. And then also reminder emails, which is about the current feature that we brought in on the tool. So you have access to send people badge emails to remind them of your event, few days, few hours, how you want it, according to how it will serve you, which you know is always very difficult before the arrival of the tool. Sometimes you need to do like direct emails and you need to do them one after the other, and it's a pain because you need to commit to a lot of time for this. I hope I satisfactorily answered your question on what the tool is. Event registration tool. That is the name of the tool. And for... just finish our question and I'll come to you, sorry. And then the question on the training. So we have a recording of that, the office hour, which has been made available several times on the Telegram group. So I don't know if you're on that Telegram group. So I think, okay, we can look into that to see what will really be useful for people. But aside from the office hour recording, we also have just a short video tutorial that explains how to onboard the tool. At the same time, we are also available to provide one-on-one support where you need it. You could just write to campaigns@wikimedia.org and then will come right to you with support how we can. And or you can also ping me wherever you can find me, or even Georges here, and we'll be happy to provide that. And Lucy could tell you before now, I jumped on a call with her, one-on-one call with her to like also help her set up her own tool and all that. We just need to get this request from you and make sure that you are happy to use the tool and where you need the support. So, but I think the one pager you are requesting is something we should put in consideration and see how we can provide that. Thank you. Yes. And that is what is so exciting about the tool. Participating only when you're on the call. But this tool gives you the agency to use this for your meetings, for your workshops, for your meetups. And what it does is that it gives like an evidence on the meta page
to show the movement how many people actually attended this call, because everyone who has registered for the event will automatically be shown on the meta page, and it helps you in reporting as well, and proof to show that yes, I had a meetup, I had a workshop where I had about, for example, 30 people who participated, and everyone can see that actually there was 30 people in that call. So there are other kinds of ways people are using this, and this is what is really intriguing for us. People are using it for workshops, they're using it for meetups, they're using it for let's say lightweight conferences. And this is also why we want to hear from you. Who knows what else you could be able to use it for? I hope I answered your question. Okay, sure.
Okay, bonjour tout le monde. René Billet du Cameroun. C'est juste un commentaire très appréciable de ce qu'est devenu l'outil, parce que j'ai été parmi les premiers testeurs de l'outil et ce que et avec la compétence, l'expérience que j'ai en tant qu'organisateur, l'outil est vraiment utile avec ce que l'outil permet de faire aujourd'hui. C'est vraiment très très appréciable et c'est un outil qui aide énormément les organisateurs, surtout dans le gain de temps, parce que faire une session, les organisateurs passaient plus de temps à inscrire des personnes, leur montrer comment remplir les formulaires et tout. Donc on gagne énormément en temps en utilisant cet outil et c'est vraiment appréciable pour les organisateurs. C'était juste un commentaire, merci.
The first tester of the tools at the beginning, and it's also an organizer. The plus is what is the gain of time. At the beginning, it was very difficult because we need to register a participant to the event, but now it's very easy. Participants need just to click and register. At the beginning, sometimes participants need to create email, to sign. Sometimes it's very difficult to also for the beginner to know how to sign on Wikipedia. Now it's very easy for using a tools.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you. My name is Iranghondra Ferdinand, with Community User Group Burundi. My question is about this tool. I can also say that it's a very good tool, but I have a question. Before we was having V0, which was tested on a beta wiki, and now we have V1, which was tested on meta. So if you do the update of the tools, it automatically goes to the organizer or organizer master request another authorization for using this tool. Thank you.
So with the two features, it's automatically accessible for you to use it. You just need to learn about what features are available in each version of the tool development. Does that answer your question? Okay, I'm going to give Georges to round up, but just before I do that, I wanted to put that question to you, Buki, and maybe to every other person. We see that we've been doing a lot of outreach to get people to have access to these two and how they can use it, but we don't seem to be seeing it maybe very effective for people. And one question I want to ask, you mentioned of a one pager. Where do you think will be the most effective for you to have access to this information you need to use the tool? I would maybe assume it's the meta page, but it seems that maybe even with the meta page is not enough, but it would be interesting to learn where you think it will be easy for you to access information to use this tool. Just a quick one, so we can round
up. Okay, thank you for that question. So I would say that the meta page, like we all know, is a documentation space and like the right place to have all information. But the reason why most people go to the meta page, but they still don't get a hang on, is because I feel like the meta page is too detailed. Yes, because sometimes you try to navigate your way through all those write-up and it gets boring. Sorry that I'm saying this. So, and having the one pager, it will be in form of like a graphics. So, you know, most times you are quickly attracted to images than write-up. So if I could see that there's a drawing showing that, oh, click here, go there. I think it's beautiful, and yes.
And I would presume that should be on commons rather
than... Yes, on commons, and it can be linked to the meta. Okay. Thank you so much. Georges,
just to say that I will translate the document in English and share with you on Telegram group. We have changed our presentation because we think that it's important to collect some feedback about the using of the tools. I will translate the document in English because this is a French version. I will translate it in English and share it to you. And add that on the document, it's possible just by reading to know how to do. It's possible to know how to do. And also we'll try also to share with you the link of our Telegram group. Yes. The next step or the next project of the product team is about event discovery. We will talk more about that in the future because we don't have a time, but it's a very good project in the of the Wikimedia movement, event discovery. Thank you for your attention.
And mentioning that we're also currently collecting feedback on how you would like to discover events and Wikimedia project. So in case if you have any thoughts on that, feel free to put it on our Telegram group or write campaigns at wikimedia.org. Thank you, everyone, and to our amazing panelists. It was good to learn from you.